Hey guys, so here I am today again with a really, really cool card trick, and I have my lovely assistant Evan here with me, and he's going to help me out with this really cool card trick. So let's go ahead and get it started. So over here I have a deck of cards, which I can actually just leave the box over here, and over here I have a deck just like this. All the cards are completely different, just like this. You can see here all the cards. So Evan, what's going to happen is first, I need to actually hypnotize you because I'm going to try a cool experiment. So, all right, so I just hypnotized you. So now that you're hypnotized, you're actually under my control. And what's going to happen is I'm going to try and control you to pick a four of a kind out of the deck, out of a shuffled deck of cards. So what's going to happen is first, I'm going to allow you to choose any card freely. So for example, if you're going to pick a king, I would try and control you to pick the other three kings in the shuffled deck. So now we're going to see which four of a kind we're going to deal with here. So go ahead and touch any card that you would like. It honestly doesn't matter. This card right here. Are you absolutely sure? You want to change your mind? No? So let's go ahead and take a look at the card that you stopped me at. So the three of diamonds. So this means we're going to try and find the other three threes in the deck. All right. So let's begin. Evan, this three of diamonds is going to be like your helper card. So go ahead and hold on to it face down. And I'm actually going to ask you to place it in anywhere you think three might be. Boom, right there. I'm going to break it at exactly the point where you stopped at. No funny moves. And as you can see here, the last card would have been the king. Like the card before it would have been the king. But you stopped at this card and this card only. The three of clubs, one of the threes. That is actually very impressive. So let's give the deck a cut. And Evan, go ahead and touch any card. Let's see if you can get a second three. This one right here. Let's see if you got it. Jack of diamonds. Okay. Oh, I know why it didn't work. It's because the helper card was face down. It would actually help if the helper card was face up. So on three, I want you to flip it over. One, two, three. And just like that, then you can get the three to appear just like that. So now, Evan, for this last three, the three of spades, go ahead and place the three of diamonds somewhere in the deck face up just like that. Perfect. So I'd say that's around half of the deck, give or take. I'm not exactly sure. But let's go ahead. We'll take a look at exactly the place where you stopped at. The three of spades. That is crazy. So, Evan, you just found you found the three of spades, and then here's the three of diamonds, the three of hearts, three of clubs. Wow. And then there's the three of diamonds. So, wow, we just found all four threes just like that. So, there is only one problem with this trick, is that I was hypnotizing you. And since I was hypnotizing you, you actually saw the three of diamonds, but it was only an illusion because here it says the card is in the box. And if I actually just take the box over here, I can actually open it up and take out the one card inside the three of diamonds. And that is basically the trick, guys. So now for the tutorial. Okay, guys, so this is a pretty cool trick I came up with, and I just sort of like combined a bunch of cool little moves and skills that I knew how to do, and I just sort of combined them all into this cool trick. And I hope you guys liked the performance of it, and here's the tutorial for how to do it. So all you're gonna need is a normal deck of cards over here, and you're gonna need a couple of things for this trick. So for this trick, you're just gonna need to pull out any four of a kind that you would like. I just got out the four threes for no apparent reason. I just thought they were good four of a kind. So once you have a four of a kind, you're gonna want to get out, if you have a blank card, get out a blank card that you don't care about, because you are going to be writing on it. But I know a lot of you do not have blank cards. So what you can do is use a joker or a double back card or just any card that you do not really care about. And you're going to take a Sharpie marker and you're going to write on it, the card is in the box, all right? Or if you don't want to do that, you can actually take a piece of like clear tape and write on the tape, the card is in the box or something like that. But I think it's a little bit cooler if it actually is like printed on the card here, or I mean written on the card here. One more thing you're gonna need is a card box. It's totally normal. Just one thing that I did was that most bicycle boxes on the back, they look like this. They have like a paragraph and they have this design with the 10 of hearts and the back design logo right there. So what I've done is I've actually just taken a random indifferent card and I've actually just taped it to the back of the box. As you can see, it has the same design as the other one I just showed you. But I taped a card on the back of it because this is actually going to help hide a move that you do later in the trick that you'll see when I teach it to you. So just take a card and tape it on the back of the box, or if you already have a box that has the card design actually on the back of it, then you do not need to do that step. But if you only have a box that looks like this, it's a very easy fix. You just take a card and tape it to the back of the box, just like that. And once you have all those things, you're ready to go. So here's the setup for the trick. You're gonna need to take the four threes, and they can be in any order you want, but just keep in mind that the top three, whichever three it is, this is going to be the card that is going to be used as the helper card, and is also going to appear inside of the box at the end of the trick. So in this case, let's just use the three of hearts as the helper card. So that's the card I'm gonna put on top of the other threes. So that's gonna be the top card right over here. And this card, the card in the box, that is actually gonna go second to last, face up, just like this. So you're gonna leave it face up, and it's gonna go second to last, and now you're ready to go, and the box, there's nothing inside of the box except for the card on the back. And then you put the cards inside of the box, close it up, and you're actually ready to go. So you go up to your spectator, and you have the box here, you can show it off. Open it up and take out all the cards. Just be sure not to flash this face down card, which is second to last. And once you take the cards out of the box, you're gonna wanna close up the box. Don't really make attention to it, but just sort of close up the box and set it aside for now, because you are gonna be making sure you flip it over so that the card design, or the card that you taped, is actually facing up just like this. So just set it off to the side, facing up just like this. So now what you can do is you can like block push over some cards to hide over this face down card, but you can show here that you have a normal deck. And also don't go all the way to the top showing the four threes, but you wanna go just in the middle showing all the shuffled cards just like this. So now what you're gonna be doing is you're gonna be telling the spectator you're actually going to hypnotize them. So this part is all acting. You're gonna snap your fingers in their face or do whatever you want, wave your hand. You're gonna act like they're hypnotized and they're gonna act like they're hypnotized too, okay? And they're gonna play along with it. It's gonna be really cool. So what's gonna happen is you're going to explain to the spectator that you're gonna try and control them to pick a four of a kind out of a shuffled deck. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna ask them to pick a card first to help designate which four of a kind we're gonna use for the trick. So what you're gonna be doing now is a force to force the top three over here, the three of hearts. So what's gonna happen is you're gonna spread through the deck just like this, and you're actually going to have them touch any card in the deck. So let's say they go ahead and touch this card over here. So now what you're gonna do is they can touch any card, but what you're gonna do is you're gonna spin it out and kind of gesture saying, okay, you could have touched any card, and you're gonna do a move called a push off pinky break where you push out the top card, pull it back, and catch a pinky break, so it's sort of separated from the deck now. So you're gonna do this as you're gesturing, so you're gonna push off the card, catch a pinky break. That was obviously exaggerated, but it looks something like that. Take the card, place it on top, holding this break, and you're gonna perform a double lift. You're gonna flip over two cards at once. So this King of Diamonds is actually the card that they chose, but you're going to flip over two cards at once, showing they picked a three of hearts. So now once you force a three, you're gonna push the double back over, and you're gonna do a move called the KM move, which looks something like this. And it's basically how to get rid of a double lift. So basically, you're just ditching this card on top of the deck as you flip over your hand just like this and flick the card with your thumb. So what you're doing is you're gonna flip it over. Your fingers here are gonna clamp down on the card. You're gonna leave the top card on the deck like this, and you're just gonna peel out the three of hearts, and you're gonna flick it with your thumb, and then you can kind of drop it on the table. And basically what you've done is you flipped over the card right beneath it and placed it on top of the deck. So looks something like this. Something like that, and that's the KM move. Just like that, all right? So now once you've done that, you're basically just free to show off this three of hearts, and you're actually gonna be handing it to them. So when you hand it to them, you're gonna hand it to them face down. Just make sure the card is face down when you hand it to them, because it's gonna matter for the next part of the trick that you do after this part. Once you hand it to them, remember you have a random card on top, which is actually the card that they picked when you spread the cards out. You left it here on top, and you just want to lose it in the middle of the deck. So you're just going to lift up half the cards and slip jog that card in the middle of the deck, just like that, all right? So now you're left with the other threes on top of the deck, which is exactly what you want. So now once the spectator is holding their helper card, the three of hearts, you're going to tell them, all right, so we're going to use the three of hearts here to try and find the other three threes, okay? So what you're going to do is you're going to hold the deck just like this, and you're going to riffle down the corner and you're just gonna ask them to place the three of hearts in face down wherever they would like. So they can go ahead and place it anywhere, just like that. And you're actually gonna break the cards exactly where they placed the three of hearts. So you're going to give them back the three of hearts just so that they can hold onto it, right? So remember the KM move, how we clamped down on that top card? We're basically going to actually do a sort of a thing like that again. So you're gonna show that the card that they could have chosen before was the Jack of Diamonds, but they stopped at this card, the Three of Clubs. So what I've just done is I've actually peeled off this card onto this packet, just like this, secretly. But I flipped my wrists over at the same time, just like this. So it looks something like this as an exposed view, just like this, as I showed the Jack of Diamonds. And then here, I've actually peeled off the Three of Clubs just like that. So that's a really, really cool hidden force. So right where they said stop, you're gonna clamp your fingers down and just hold the card down as you just rotate this packet up, and you're gonna flip both your wrists over as you tap. So you could have picked the Jack of Diamonds right before, but you stopped exactly at this point. Peel it off and actually just drop this pack on top, because that will make sure the other threes are right there. And now they have picked the Three of Clubs, just like that. So now you're probably wondering, why is this the card is in the box card second to last? And not just on the bottom. Well, this card is actually here to cover that card when you do this move, when you show the bottom card. Because this card is actually covering that face down card, because you wouldn't want it to look like this, and you would see a face down card here. That would look very suspicious. So you would want this card to cover it up, then you drop it down. So now you have the other threes. So now you're gonna do this move to actually lose the bottom card in the middle of the deck. Now, if you know any other methods than what I'm about to teach you, that's fine, go ahead and use them. So all of this is after they pick the first three. So after they find the first three, you're gonna get a break underneath the bottom card. You're going to swing cut over half of the cards just like so. And you're actually going to be, as you're swing cutting it, you're actually gonna grab the card with your pinky just like this. And you're gonna get a pinky break underneath the card so that when you swing cut the cards, you can ride that card right along with it. Drop the pack in your right hand on the table and drop this on top. So you've actually just lost that card in the middle of the deck, and now the card is in the box card is actually on the bottom. So the next part of the trick is pretty cool. It's actually just a shake change. So I'll teach you guys how to do that right now. So you're gonna spread through the cards and have them touch any card. So they can touch any card, and this is not the force that I just taught you. This is just any card. Flip it over, and it's going to be not a three, obviously, unless they choose a top card, but you tell them to pick a card in the middle, so don't worry, that won't happen. They pick a random card, and you're gonna get a pinky break underneath the top card, which is actually a three. Three of diamonds in this case. So you're gonna get a pinky break as you're talking, you're gonna place the card on top, and make sure the helper card that they have is face down. That's very important that's face down, because you're gonna explain, oh, it went wrong because the helper card was face down. It would actually help if the helper card was face up. This is sort of like misdirection for them, because you're gonna say, on three, I want you to flip over the Three of Hearts. So you're gonna say one, two, three, they're gonna flip over the Three of Hearts. But what you're doing is the shake change, which looks something like that. What you're doing is you're holding this double here. You have a three and the random card back to back. You're gonna hold onto the corners just like this. Basically the corners with the pips on them. So the corners with the letters or the numbers. Your index finger is going to contact the long edge here, and you're basically going to be shaking your hand back and forth, and your index finger is going to pull the card towards you and then push it down to flip it 180 degrees, just like that. And you're going to do this as you're shaking your hand, and you're basically going to flip over the card just like this. But you have to really shake it and flip it over kind of fast, like that speed. And you have to do it as you kind of accent on the So you have to kind of shake it and then boom, just like that, and it will kind of change, and do it as they flip over the three, and that will look really, really magical. So once you've done the shake change, you have a double right here. So you're going to place the double here just on top of the deck, place the three down, show it's normal. And remember how I slip jogged that top card, that random card in the middle? Do that exact same thing again, because this is a random card and you want to get it lost in the middle. So just lose that card in the middle of the deck and you'll be fine. So now for this next part, you're gonna take their helper card, the Three of Hearts, and you're gonna ask them to place it in face up anywhere they would like, and say roughly around half of the deck. So let's just say they place it in right here, and make sure it's face up, because that's gonna matter. So now they place it in face up, and basically you're gonna wanna get the card from their perspective to your perspective, just like this. So, and you can do that in a natural way by saying, okay, you're gonna hold the deck with your thumb and index finger, or just fingers right there. thumb and index finger should be fine, right on the center. You're going to use your index finger here to pivot it. And a natural move for this would be, I'd say that's around half of the deck, wouldn't you think? So you're going to do that as you're saying that, and now the card is right there. So now you can actually push down and up to catch a pinky break just like this. And now what you're going to do is called a turnover pass. Now, I have taught a Herman pass before on this channel, and I will leave a link right up here so you can watch that if you do not know how to do a Herman pass, but I'll do a quick little overview on the turnover pass. So what's going to happen is your index finger is going to curl under. You're going to take the bottom half holding the break. You're going to take the bottom half holding the three. You're going to flip it over, and you're going to take this half over here and also flip it over at the same time, just like this. And it's basically going to do that really fast, and it's going to make it look like this card that they just placed is right next to the three. But what you've just done is actually cut the cards. The three is right here on top, the three of hearts. So basically, this card is the card in the box card, and since it was on the bottom, and since this card was on the top, they kind of meet in the middle since you cut the cards. If you think of cutting the cards as like a circular motion, they'll kind of just meet in the middle just like that. So let's just go through that again so I can show you what it looks like at full speed. I'm not really going to do an entire tutorial on the turnover pass, but you can look up tutorials for it on YouTube. There are many out there. So go ahead, get a pinky break, and this is what it would look like at full speed just like that. So it just kind of looks like you're flipping over the deck, and just kind of do it on the offbeat when you're talking. Spread through the deck until you reach the face down card and the three. And this is going to look like this is the three of hearts and the three of spades, which it landed impossibly next to. So now you'll see that the three of hearts, the helper card, is right here face down on the bottom. So don't spread all the way to it, obviously, because you want to hide that card. But once you have it, you're actually going to get a pinky break underneath it. And then you're going to get a thumb break, just like this. What you're going to do, make sure these cards are kind of back on the table. I didn't do this very naturally in the performance, but I'll show you a much more better looking way right now in the tutorial. So what you're going to do is you're going to secretly drop off this three of hearts on top of the box, just like this. And it's going to look something like that. And you're going to be distracting the spectator. You're just going to place your hand here on the box just casually. And you're going to hold this thumb break. You're just going to place it on the box casually. As you say, all right, let's double check we have all of them. Three of clubs, three of diamonds, three of hearts, three of spades. And you're just going to be sliding forward each three across the table like this. And that will just give you misdirection so you can just casually place your hand on top of the box. And now you're just going to lift up your hand. As you slide forward the three of spades, you're just going to lift your hand up and quickly spread through the deck. And now all their attention will be here. And this box looks exactly like it did 5 seconds ago. But look, you've actually just placed the three of hearts on top of it. But since you have this face down card, it completely blends in and you cannot tell the difference at all. Now you can show the deck is completely normal, actually, and you're almost done with the trick. So now you have to say, now remember, I was hypnotizing you this entire time. So there is only one problem with this trick, and that is that there was no three of hearts this entire time. And they'll be able to see here, it says the card is in the box. So now you're going to point to this card and say, the card is in the box, and you're going to grab the box just like this. Thumb on the long edge, middle finger, and other middle finger, ring finger, and pinky finger on the other long edge. Index finger on the center of the card right here. That's very important. If you don't have it there, it might kind of go all loose like this. So if you want to push down, just push down really hard so that the card stays aligned with the box. Just quickly pick it up and flip it over, and you're just going to hold the box like this. But your wrist is going to be flipped over, obviously. And you're going to open up the flap just like this. Your thumb is going to go right here inside of the empty box. And your fingers are going to go right here on the bottom of the box. And what's going to happen is you're going to just be pulling your hand out. And you're basically just going to be taking the card out from the bottom. But if you kind of close this flap down, it just looks like you're taking the card out of the box. And then quickly just set the box down. And now you can show that the three of hearts was impossibly inside of the box the entire time. And that should just make absolutely no sense to the spectator. And now everything is pretty much examinable. I mean, even if you do have the card on the box, I mean, it is just a random card. So, I mean, it doesn't really matter, honestly. But I mean, everything else is examinable. Like the deck is completely examinable. There's no other like threes or anything. All of these cards are also normal, just like this, every single one. And all this is normal. So that's basically the trick, guys. So I really hope you guys like that cool trick I came up with. I spent a lot of time trying to perfect it and hopefully it paid off. So hopefully you guys like that. And I'm gonna see you guys for my next video. Bye.